this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate this beautiful eclipse. And the animation is procedural. We don't use any keyframes. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. I've already added a background, a solid with a pretty dark gradient ramp. With no layer selected, we double-click on the ellipse tool to create a round shape. We name it silhouette or planet. Easier word. Then let's go into the ellipse path 1 group and adjust the size. 500 by 500 pixels. And let's use black solid fill. No stroke. Next, we create the lights that shine behind the shape. It should be planet with a T at the end. We duplicate the layer, Command or Control D, and rename it Light 1. Let's move it behind the planet, meaning below. Instead of a fill, let's hide it. We use a gradient stroke. Let's set the width to 150 pixels. Then choose two gradient colors. Cyan and neon green, for example. The colors are totally up to you, of course. Let's quickly adjust the start and end. Next, we add a trim path animator. Choose it from the add menu here. To animate the length of the path, we animate the end property with expressions. First, we want to make sure it sticks to a certain animation pattern. We add seed random with a capital R and in parentheses add index. Semicolon. Any seed random number is linked to a unique animation pattern. In this case, it refers to the index number of the layer, making sure each layer we add has a different animation pattern. Then we add the wiggle expression. In parentheses, 0.2, 40. 0.2 times per second, the end value animates by max 40 in both directions. And if we set the start value to 50%, it moves between 10 and 90%. Let's go into the gradient stroke 1 group and set the line cap property to round cap. We need to think ahead. To be able to change the speed of the light animation for all lights easily, we use an expression control. We add a null object, name it speed. I usually move the expression controls to the top. Then we go to effects, expression controls, and add a slider control. Name it speed and set the range from 0 to 3. 3 should be fast enough. Then we link our expression to the slider control. Select the layer, press E twice to see all expressions. Let's open the slider property as well. We select 0.2 and replace it with a link to the speed slider control. Awesome. Now, let's animate the rotation property as well. We press Shift R to additionally open it. Then we copy the expression, add an expression to the rotation property and paste it. Instead of 40, we add 360. We want the light to be able to rotate the whole way. And now, you can easily change the speed of both properties. That's how you create animations fast and effectively. Learn more about expressions with my free expression sheet. You'll be surprised how expressions can change and speed up your workflow. Create easy-to-use templates. Create animations that aren't possible with keyframes, like a particles rig, for example. Once set up, you can use it again and again. I know it's overwhelming at the beginning. That's why in my course, we start from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. A more than 50-page long expression sheet will accompany you, plus bonus content with even more application examples. Upgrade your skills and learn how to animate with expressions in After Effects. The links are in the description. All right, now we have to make it look awesome. We add Gaussian blur and blur it. A quick search in the effects and presets window. Here it is. Let's set the blurriness to around 400. Deselect repeat edge pixels. Then we set the blending mode of the layer to add. Let's add more lights. We duplicate the layer, change the stroke gradient colors. Contrasting colors like yellow and pink, maybe. We duplicate one of the light layers once more. Let's go for purple and blue. all the animation part is taken care of by the expressions. Then let's add three more. We duplicate the layer and decrease the stroke width to 80 this time, and the blurriness to 160. Let's choose two colors, purple and white. It creates a nice glow here. Two more, green and cyan, and a bright purple and orange. You can add as many lights as you want. Everything is automatically animated. Quickly change the speed and the animation feels very different. And finally, some finishing touches. We add an adjustment layer. You can see the lights changing when you add a new solid. That's because the animation patterns change due to the new layer index numbers. Let's name it Shine and add CC Light Rays. We add it. Intensity around 180. Radius around 400. Warp softness 130. Let's position the center somewhere left above the lights. And it all seems less clean and it adds an overall shine. Finally, we add noise to avoid color bending. Amount 5%, and we don't use color noise. This is how you create an ambient light loop easily with basic expressions. Check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.